Hi, this is MC Jetty for a porting tutorial from Minecraft 1.17 to 1.18. So many of you will probably want to port from 1.16, but for that I refer to the 1.16 porting tutorial that I made earlier. So it's probably easiest to just port from 1.16 to 1.17 and then from 17 to 18. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do right now. First of all, some information. My wiki will and already contains some information about porting. I have some useful links, and here I have described the steps because I've already prepared the port. So basically, these were the steps that I had to do. There's of course the Forge site, which currently has this as the latest version for 1.18. I will explain later, and this too. So to start, what I do, I have a GitHub. I don't know if you have a GitHub. If you don't, then this is not important. But I want to start porting this tutorial. It's the one that started in 1.14. I want to start porting from this version, because that's closest, and I'm creating a new branch right here. Okay, so let's clone that. YouTube v 1.18. Okay, you can do this any way you want using Git. If you don't use Git, then this doesn't matter. But basically what I'm doing, I made by doing this clone, I made a copy of the 1.17 code and I checked it out here. So basically if you don't use Git, you can just as well make a copy of your 1.17 project in a new folder where you will start the porting. So this is still 1.17 code, it's just named 1.18. I'm going to open this project. It's in another screen, so you can't see it, but it will appear in a moment. Hold on. Yep. So I open, let me show you what I'm doing. So I have open file or project, and I'm open build.gradle. Okay, it says open as a project. All right, and now it will open. So it will do a bit of work first. Yeah, and that's it. So, but this is still 1.17. We are going to do a bit of preparation work from here, you can download the MDK, which is useful because it contains the latest Gradle stuff. So what I did do now is I extracted that in MDK. You can use it using regular files, it's okay. Using File Manager, for example. I'm on Linux, but on Windows this works just as well, but with different comments and different I'm kind of assuming that you know how to work with a computer and know how to handle files and move and copy stuff and do shell stuff. So basically we need this and we want that in here. Okay, so we updated a few things. If we go back to IntelliJ, you now see that these are modified and Gradle wrapper properties modified. That's the latest version of Gradle. It's already doing things to refresh the new Gradle. Now we need to modify things in here, and I made some notes on that in this file. Okay, so clone the 1.17 version of your project. The next step that you need to do is to change the JDK of your project to Java 17, SDK default 17. Yes, because Minecraft 1.18, you needs Java 17. I have a link here to Adoption where you can download the correct JDK. That also works for Windows, by the way. So that's on my wiki. Okay, so we did that. Okay, so now the build.cradle, there we will have to do most work. Basically, this is all good. This is all okay. I want to get the one prop too, but we will get it from the Curse Maven. Hold on. Let me copy that from another file. Because the Terach Maven currently isn't working for 1.17 or higher. Okay. We can't use Parchment yet, because Parchment for 1.18 isn't ready. You could use the 1.17 Parchment, but I think it's better to use this. It's a matter, yeah, it will both work. Okay, so just fixing some dependencies. Like that. Yeah, I'm copying from a test project that I made. So that makes it somewhat easier. Let's also simplify this. Okay, so that's JI, because JI is already ported to 1.18 and the one prop we get from the Curse Maven. We also need to fix these versions. Actually, top version I don't use. Okay. All right, so this step we already did, and now we can refresh Gradle. So you go to this step, you press refresh Gradle. This will cause errors because I probably forgot something, let's say. Let's see, I mean, usually you look at, I may have made a typo there. Oh yeah, I forgot to fix something right here. Hold on. This is probably caused by this line. That's a better Maven to use for Forge. Let's see if it works now. No. Hold on, let me debug this. Okay, one thing I did forget, this needs to be set to 17, but I don't think that will be the problem. Okay, so the only other difference, or will it be the problem? Let's try it out. I was comparing the differences between the project where I already did it. Yeah, that's actually the problem. You really need to set it to Java 17. So we let it refresh, that's done. And then we can do fork again IntelliJ runs like this. And now you should have a run client. It will of course not work, because there will be many compilers if we try to compile. Yeah, we get lots of problems. A lot of problems can be fixed automatically. So there is a migration script for IntelliJ, this one, and we will run that now. So basically, if you go visit that, that's this file. So you need to download this. You go to the raw version and you download that. And at the bottom there are instructions. So on Windows you go to this version, this directory, and you put that file there. On Linux you go there. So I put a migration file here. And when that file is there, you probably need to restart IntelliJ. After that you should have in the refactor menu, migrate, and there should be this. And you run that, and you do refactor, and you see there's already one error less. that we have to worry about. But don't worry, plenty of other errors to fix. So I made a summary of the things I had to change, but there is also another thing that is very useful. There is this link, which goes to here, which summarizes a lot of changes in Forge. So things that have been renamed. And the first one here is one of them. If you go look Forge container type, it's now called Forge menu type. So we can just change that and it will work. And this here the errors are gone. So in my wiki, I summarized some of these changes that I had to do. So let's go over them. Constants is gone. Let's fix all of them at once. So we go look, open in find window. So we remove the import and all these constants are now in block. And if you go look at block, so block update all, that's actually the one we need. Because all ifs value 3, that's 1 plus 2, so that's neighbors and clients. And we can get rid of this. Same here. Okay. Okay, so these are simple changes. Okay, and then all right, next one. Yeah, render world last event has been renamed to render level last event. In general, everything world is now called level. So everything that's called world will have level now. This is get post stack instead of, I think there's another error here. Yeah, this is also changed. Now you need to do this. So the constructor has become private. If you go check this out, you see it will call get update tag anyway. So this is actually the same at what was here before. Just another way to do it. Oh, I forgot one of these. Okay. All right, next error. Yeah, the capabilities have changed considerably. Capability inject is no longer exist. It has been changed. Let's copy that. So basically what you do now is use this. And these go away. So you declare a capability and you do capability manager.get, but this you still have to register. And that's in my case in mod setup. So this register goes away. You no longer need that. And we subscribe to an event. Oh, that's not what I want. Register capabilities event. So that's how you do capabilities now. So that's also different. Yeah, these things are simple. That's simply get map has become get atlas, get items tag. Oh yeah, this should be gather components instead of pre. So the things have moved there for setting the maximum width of tooltip. Get render type. Most of these changes are pretty easy. If you don't know what a change to, usually you get an IntelliJ smart enough to suggest the one that has the correct return. So that's usually very easy. Okay, this has changed a bit more. So this has gone and get no nice biome. Has a different signature. The reason the parameters are bad is because I don't have parchment. Okay, so basically like this. So while we are doing the biome, let's also do the chunk generator because there are a bit more changes there. So this has changed. What I do is then control I, and I see it will probably be build surface. This is a new parameter. And then just remove this and it will work. Fill from noise. Let's see what has changed there. Fill from noise. Okay. And chunk access that. And then there's still a few errors that are missing. So these have to be changed. So to find out what you need to give here, what I do is look at examples. And since I think a good example, a simple example to use, is the for the flat world level source. And it just uses this. So I'm just going to copy that. I'm guessing these are X, Y, and Z coordinates. So just like that. I go check flat. Yeah, this is simply empty. And these are good values, so I'm going to use these. Like that. Okay, so I'm going to use a regular height and sea level at normal level. Okay, so this is how you can make larger worlds, by the way, taller worlds. Okay, so another change here, this one requires control P, block entity type. So we are going to give that as a parameter because we now need it. And let's check here. So voila. Also finished. We actually have no more errors, but that doesn't mean it's done. There's still a few things that you need to fix. So you should no longer override save. That has changed. Instead, you should override save additional like that. So I'm going to go to the this one, and I'm going to check. Yeah, that's from Forge, but this one also uses save. So things have changed a bit, and save is actually preserved. The idea is that you don't implement override those anymore. Instead, you use save additional. It's actually also one line easier, so not a big deal. One other thing that has changed, and actually it hasn't changed, it has changed in 1.17, so it was actually a bug in the 1.17 code. It's safer to just test for this. For the item handler, it's okay, but this one actually doesn't work properly the very first time if there is no tag yet. And this also needs to be get. Yeah, so this will fix. You don't need to compound here, but actually problem is if you don't do that, this will error. Okay, so if we did everything right, we should be able to run. Let's try it out. All right, let's just create a basic world, proceed. World chain in 1.18 is it's a bit slower, which is to be expected given the changed world height. It will be interesting to see how Lost Cities will port to this. Okay, so you see the one probe is there. And let's check. Oh yeah, stupid thing. Okay, yeah, look around. So let's grab all these and see if they work properly. Okay, so seems to work. Let's grab some diamonds. It's generating energy, so that works fine. All right, this looks good. This looks perfect. There was an error there. I've seen that before. It's probably, yeah, I need to check that. Let's see what's happening here. So this one is zero. I'm not sure why it is zero though. Handle update tag. What does self do? That's, yeah, I can probably fix for this. It maybe the first time this is actually zero. So let's add that as well. But it did work, and it can also mimic things like that. So, and the entity works too. Okay.